Okay, so today I'm doing a healing video using the various tools of modality that we use. One of my favorites that I like to use is the Native American turtle rattle. And it's not only indigenous to the Aboriginal people that were here. So what a lot of people don't know, by now everybody is knowing, that so-called African Americans did not, even though life began in Africa, but life began all over this planet. And they did not come here through the middle passages. They were already here. What is called the Americas? Is this America part of Haiti, Cuba, Jamaica, Trinidad, Barbados? All those West Indian islands are part of what's called the Americas. And in those islands, we had different groups of Aboriginal people, okay? I know in Jamaica, we had the Arawak Indians, the Carib Indians, Tiana, we had various groups. And these were the original copper-skinned people. Not what we're told that were natives. They came later, and they are a mixture of various European groups. With that being out of the way, we use this rattle, okay? And this, these healing tools are excellent for removing negative energy, for calming a restless spirit, and, you know, rebalancing things within the body. I know my sons, they have gone at it. Amun-Ra and Heru, they're fighting and whatever. And I've had to come in the room and shake the rattle. And when I shake the rattle, the energy shifts in the room. And then they're peaceful. Why is that bright ass light in my face? So now I am going to use the rattle over Heru. Okay? And we do it over his crown chakra. We go all down his body. We go to the bottom of his feet. And at this point, you can be reciting any incantation. Stand up, Heru. Stand up, Heru. Hello. Lift up the bottom of your feet. Push up the bottom of your feet. Okay? And these is one of our healing modalities. And we go all around the body. Come lay down. And at this point, we can be reciting any kind of incantation, mantras, whether it be to Oshun, Nana Buruku, the ancestors, or Set, whatever. Okay, whatever pantheon, you can recite a healing mantra. You can also use the Bible, Psalms 23, or even at this point, the Psalms were written for protection. They were written for purification. They were written for guidance by our ancient mothers called the Sibyls, the Black Bird, the Pythias. Okay, and before it was hijacked by patriarchy and given to these various patriarchal priests and whatnot, these belong to us. So we take it back, and what we do, let's say your birthday is the 18th. You can do Psalms 18 or 8 plus 1 equals 9. Those would be your power psalms, okay? And when you say where it says, O Goddess, O God, it's O Goddess, or O Lord, it's O Lordess, okay? And at this point, okay, you can recite those healing words, mantras. Okay, so this is a Native American rattle. Okay? We also have the singing bowl that we can gently use. Okay, to go all over the body, front and back. Okay? We also use, this is called a chevron quartz. Okay? And a chevron quartz is a crystal. A healing crystal that we use, and we pass it all over the body. okay? And we use different crystals for different purpose, okay? In healing and picking up different energies. Now, the reason why we use a egg-shaped crystal is because the egg represents cleansing. It represents the cosmic egg, okay? And we can also use different forms of crystals to go over the body, okay? To go over the body like a magnet, okay? Picking up negative energy, okay? And at this point, you would be using incense. You can use various oils. We also use the sistrum. The sistrum was not just a tool to call the goddess. It was used in healing and purification ritual. And at this point, we can just recite a mantra. Ankh, Uja, Seneb. 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 Okay? That's one of our healing modalities. We also use what's called a sonic healing bell. Okay, and we go over the heart chakra. The root chakra. And we go all down. Stand up, Heru. Okay, and you can keep this on him. I'm going to get something. Keep this on him, which I should have gotten before I started this. In this healing modality, and I'll move this out of the way and sit on my ancestral altar. Okay, come here, Heru. We use an egg. Come here, stand up. When women or men come to us for cleaning, that they have been hexed, okay? We can use an egg to clean them, okay? And we would go over the head, all over the body. It's like a magnet. Stick out your arms. It's like a magnet picking up the root work, okay? Picking up the negativity. And you want to get this egg as fresh as possible. And what you would do is use this in a bathroom. Sometimes if they have spiritual entities attached, spiritual STDs that's attached to them, okay? Lift up the bottom of your foot. You would also want to clean the bottom of the foot, okay? You would want to clean the palm of the hand. Give me the palm of your hand, okay? The palm of your hand. And what you would do a total of 9 eggs in succession. Now, I have on my sweats, but this isn't what I'd be wearing. I'd be wearing ceremonial gear, okay? My head would be wrapped in white, I'd be dressed in all white or black, and I would have a cord tied around my waist because depending on how much incubi or succubi that's attached to this individual, I wouldn't want it attaching itself to me. So, and there are different portals that they can enter: your hand, top of your head, your belly button, the bottom of your feet. And so you would want to get cascarilla and draw a cross in your hand, okay, the bottom of your feet and get a cord to tie around your midsection that you've already dressed and to wrap your head in white. And so when you go over, you use the egg and you pick up all this negative energy, okay? You pick up all this negative energy. And what you would do, you would bust it in the toilet. And you want to watch the egg to see what comes out of it. Because sometimes, depending on how messed up people are, you can see worms crawling out the eggs. You know, I've seen snakes crawl out of an egg. You can see the egg, instead of being yellow, it will be blood red with black dots in it, okay? These are all the negative root work that we pick up out of the person, okay? We can also use feathers. Stand up. We can, and I'm just going to borrow my little ancestral feather here from my little, from one of my little ancestral dolls. And we clean off with a feather, okay? Of course, we would have the charcoal or the bamboo incense going with different incense, the resins, not these, the resins. Frankincense, myrrh, white corpal, Palo Santo, Three Kings, sage, everything that's pounded down into that along with herbs and oils. But for this, we're just going to use this. And this is actually an excellent cleaning tool. These are crow's feathers. So whenever you're walking and you see these crow's feathers, you pick them up because it's a sign. Bird feathers tell you that you're on the right path. And you can put them on your altar or put them around. Okay? That's fine. You can put them all around. And at this point, you can just be doing any kind of mantras. Lay down. Okay. Any kind of mantras or any kind of, like I said, incantation. Now, this one I'm going to use. This was probably from 2006 when I was initiated in Lukumi, which I have since left. Omi tutu, ona tutu, ile tutu, tutu la roye. I respect all of my ancestors that sit at your feet, Oludemare. Attention to all of my ancestors with light all over the world. I do not say just Africa and Jamaica because I have ancestors all over the place. And at this point, you can say your mother and your grandmother's maiden name. I salute all of my ancestors with light all over the world. And at this point, you would also want to include your father's name and his mother's name. Your father's last name and his mother's maiden name. And you also salute the rest of your ancestors, those whom you know. I salute my ancestors that rest with the dead. Okay? Your mother's side, your father's side. I salute all of my ancestors with life, of those whom I do not know the names of. I salute all of my ancestors who died in the Middle Passage. I salute all of my ancestors who died in slavery. Now we get into the petition. Keep away death, sickness, illness, tragedy, confusion, overwhelmed, undeserved punishment, police, curse, witchcraft, physical harm, poverty, loss. Give to me peace, immortality, fortune, honor, wisdom, wealth, knowledge, food, good character, good work, victory and success. And we use, keep it on him, we use our staff, okay? And I have here a staff that I use. And this is my ancestral staff. Let's get a good close-up there of the staff for my daughter Hathor. And we would tap this. 1, 2, 3, okay? We tap this, and at this point, we can sit down and converse with our ancestors, okay? And when we are finished, we listen. Is there anything else that you have to say to me? Ancestors, may I be released? Is there anything else you want me to know? And at this point, they can communicate with you and they can tell you X, Y, Z, or you're fine. You can close the circle and you can tap again. 1, 2, 3. Also, in opening a circle with the ancestors, when we do rituals outside, we use it and we tap the ground and we call them. Okay? And so, keep it on him. That's what we use. And so, these are some of the healing modalities. We also have what you put into the incense pot, and you can go around the body. You see in the Catholic Church, when you see them doing the censers, okay, they're removing negative energy. See, things are right there being hidden in wide open, okay? They know, because that's one of the most powerful religions, okay? Because they have a lot of the secrets that was stolen from these ancient cultures that they use. If you've ever seen the movie Van Helsing, when you've seen all of them underneath the Vatican working the different religions, working to go around and investigate paranormal activities, which happens on this planet quite a lot. So again, also in this bottle, herbs were boiled. And there are different herbs like basil, bay leaf, cloves, cinnamon sticks, and added are, lavender, myrrh, frankincense, and camphor oil, whatever, peppermint, all these kinds of oils, and it is kept in a mixture that I use to spray around the place, you know what I'm saying? I can even use it, spray myself down sometime, and it has Florida water in it. So we can do a little, sometimes spray the top of the head, okay? Okay, yeah, and we can do the chest, okay? And we can rub this in, okay? And sometimes I'll just spray myself, you understand? So we keep a bottle of this, and these are essential oils. The herbs are first boiled in a pot and steeped and cooled, okay? And they are poured in, various herbs. You can research the different types of herbs for purification, okay? Hyssop is one of them. I mean, there's so many different herbs. And you keep it in a spray bottle, add Florida water to it, sea salt. And what this does, this is a purification. And sometimes I can spray it in my ancestral things. Spray it around the altar and around, and like I said, even spray when I need a bit of cleansing, okay, and I can do my crown chakra, yes, ooh, that feels good, that feels good, yes.
I can feel it.
Yes, you can feel it too?
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. So again, this was a video on different methods of purification, stabilizing, and removing negative energy, okay, from the body, even from the environment. When I come down and I use my rattle, you know what I'm saying? This rattle, I can't speak enough about this rattle. Everyone really should have one, and it works differently for different people. I have a fellow sister witch in up in Philadelphia, and she'll use hers. And when she speaks it, when she shakes it, she starts to speak in another language. Her peoples were like Cherokee, Sioux, I don't know, probably mangling that, Blackfoot, and some other things. And so they come through and they start speaking. She starts speaking in another language. She used it as a method of divination. You can use it, shake it, close your eyes. And it calls your ancestors. It calls them. Now, I'm not going to do this on camera because I don't want nobody walking through my body and You know, I'm speaking a different language, so I'm just going to stop right here. But we can use this to call our ancestors, and some of our ancestors will walk right through you, okay? And this is when they can give you downloads. They can give you messages. They can have you doing stuff. I know sometimes when they walk through me and they possess me, they direct me to go and get dressed and tend to the altar or do something, okay? So again, these are the various things that we do. All right? All right.